Thank you, Kim. Well, it's being called the latest example of corporate greed. Wells Fargo's plan to spend thousands of dollars for a series of upcoming retreats in Las Vegas. The bank, which recently bought out Charlotte-based Wachovia, canceled that trip at the last minute. Bill O'Neill shows us a lot of consumers are not letting the bank off the hook quite so easily.
Congressional critics say Wells Fargo, the new owner of Wachovia, is the latest example of corporate America not getting the message. Wells Fargo planned to send its top mortgage sellers to Wynn Las Vegas and Encore Las Vegas hotels this Friday as part of an all-expense-paid trip called a, quote, recognition event by the bank. At first, Wells Fargo defended the plan, saying, quote, recognition events are still a part of our culture. But news of the Vegas trip didn't go over well with the public.
I just think it's wrong. I'm looking for a job now. You know, I'm my only supporter, self-support. So these people that are going to Vegas, you know, and the banks that are sending them, it's just wrong.
Well, it's abuse of money power. Basically, it's a catch-22. Only the big bucks win.
Our people here are struggling, so I don't think that's right. We're paying all the taxes and all that, and they study more taking more money from us and giving it to people who already have money.
After members of Congress criticized Wells Fargo, the bank decided to cancel the Vegas trip. The company says it has not planned any other recognition events for this year. Wells Fargo is not the only financial institution to take bailout money and schedule recognition events for its employees. Morgan Stanley wanted to send its employees to Monte Carlo this spring. That trip, too, has been canceled. In Greensboro, Bill O'Neill, WXII 12 News. Back to you.
Thank you, Bill. Wells Fargo received $25 billion in taxpayer bailout.